friends. Happy Saturday. Can you believe it? Last Saturday of August. The time has just been flying by. Oh my goodness. So, much better day today. Yesterday, yeah, my headache finally went away, but Jerry had went and bought some Roma tomatoes after all. I stayed home and he bought it from our local Amish place, 25 pounds. And I knew that they had to be done. The best would have been yesterday or today at the latest. So yesterday, I don't know, about 2:30, I got up, was able to start writing. Sorry, just got done eating the dehydrated apples. So I went out there. He was already taking a siesta. And so I started on the Roma tomatoes. I washed them. I had a little station set up with a bowl of water and I washed them and then I cut off and cored the ends, and there wasn't hardly any that had any blemishes on them. They felt really good as I was doing them. So I got that all done and got them all quartered into a big old stock pot and started to cook them down. I was going to make pasta sauce, marinara sauce, you know, the stuff that you use for spaghetti and on your pizzas and all that stuff. And so in the Ball Blue Book, there is a recipe that you can do tomato juice, sauce, or tomatoes. Just a second. Sorry, Jerry came in. And the Blue Book, and all you have to do is cook down your tomatoes, and that there is a three different spices that you can add. You can do Mexican spice or Italian seasoning, that's the one I did, or Cajun seasoning. And the whole idea is that you put your either citric acid or lemon juice in the jar, and then you mix up this thing of different spices, and then you put them into the jar, and then you pour your hot tomato juice or sauce over it. And we did sauce. So it's supposed to give us, it says, the spices said 6. But the recipe said 7 and we ended up with 9. But I had 25 pounds of Roma tomatoes. And so they started cooking about 3 o'clock. And then you had to reduce it once you immersion blended it. And then I took the food mill. And that time Jerry was in helping. And so we put it through there so that we could get all the seeds out and any extra big pieces. And then once we did that, then we divided it up amongst two smaller pots. One was a Dutch oven. I should have gotten both Dutch ovens out. And the other one was a regular heavy bottom stock pot. And then you're supposed to cook them on medium high until you reduce it in half. So needless to say, that took that took like two and a half hours to reduce it. And then our son Landon, who's down in Indiana, was going to be playing his first football game. And his dad, our son, and family, they went down there to surprise him. So they were able to watch him play football. And the schools down there have made it so that they will live stream it. So we were able to sit here while we were waiting for the tomato mixture to reduce, watch him play. I miss that boy so much. That's the only bad part about divorce, is when one parent lives up here and the other one lives 7 hours away. So, but he His dad is 6'3", and I think that he is 6'3½" or 6'4", because the picture that they took of them together, he was standing a little taller than his daddy. So anyways, we didn't finish up that tomato stuff until I think 10:45 last night. And then I had done the other half of my yogurt also yesterday. And so by that time, I could, you know, finish that up. And so I got a lot of yogurt, I'm telling you, which is good. So that was all done. So today has been a laid back day. I had my smoothie this morning, and then for lunch I had a turkey salad, and not for sure about supper. Last night for supper did not have anything because just wasn't feeling good with my head and stuff. Jerry had a small plate of nachos and cheese as we were watching Land and Play. So, but because we have no meat in the house, and I really don't feel like hot dogs today, even though if I said to Jerry, because we have corn dogs, you know, he could fix corn dogs because that's what we were going to have yesterday, you know, but we'll see. But anyways, so the sauce turned out, it looks, we haven't tasted it, but it looks really good. It's nice and thick, like what you would get from the store. Just like our tomato soup is thick, like from the store. With the tomato soup, we basically use tomato soup for not just tomato soup, it's for our goulash base. And so, but if we were going to eat it as a tomato soup, you just add heavy cream, I guess, is what the majority of the people do. On, I don't know why you couldn't add a little bit of milk to it just to give it that creaminess that you expect when you get the tomato soup. So we got that all done. I went out this morning. Jerry went to an auction, and which was about an hour from us, and I stayed home. It was mainly tools, is what he told me. And so I just sat here this morning, and I had a couple cups of coffee, did my devotions, and crocheted on my fairy dust right here. I'm on the back side. I just started row 3 of 12 and went out to the garden and picked a good handful, a big handful of green beans and yellow and purple beans. And so now I have about 3 cups of beans all snapped, not enough for a quart, but normally I would do them in pint-sized jars anyways. And I have more out there. They're just they're like in between before they're ready to be picked. So I'm hoping with this heat that has come out for the next few days, I'll check them tomorrow morning, and if they're not ready, I know they will be by Monday. So if I can get enough picked to make 2 pints, and then I have some carrots that I will slice and dice and put them in pint jars, then I'll process them all at the same time. So, but other than that, just taking it easy today. I've been starting to knit on our son's second sock, and I am 2 more rows, and then I can start the heel, and the heel will be in like a dark green like this. So I just have 2 more rounds to do on that, and then I can get that going. And then I thought about, I was going to do Riker, our other grandson, who is going to be 12 in October, his pair of socks for Christmas. And I had this orange and black, it's more charcoal and orange, because his school colors are black and orange. And I thought, well, that'll be perfect for him. And his feet are big enough that he's almost wearing my shoe size. So my thought was he's still growing because he's going to be 12. I'll do Jerry's shoe size and he can grow right into them as far as lengths go. So this afternoon after lunch, I went into my sewing area, into my craft closet where I have all of my crafts and everything. Pulled out the tote that had that in there, and I pulled it out, and I'm looking at it, and I'm thinking, well, this feels really nice, because it's an older one, and I started reading what it was, and it was, what was it, I have to think, this is 100%, and there was three items in it. It was, it's fingering. It had nylon in it, superwash merino, and it had cashmere. I think like 15% cashmere. I thought, nope, they're not going to go to a 12-year-old boy's socks. So I told Jerry, he says, great. Now I got to rethink what I want to do for him and all my sock stuff. That will become a scarf, a cowl, hat, gloves. Maybe I'll do them in glove. Maybe I haven't done those. That just came to me. Maybe I will do those in the fingerless mitts because they are super soft. So I was looking and looking and nothing really was saying Riker to me. There was one that was a yarnable that I got a while back, and I think it was called Grow something. Anyways, it looks like sunflowers. And I remember a year ago when I got that, and he said, when he saw it, he says, well, I would wear that. So, but that was a year ago. But I still might knit those up for him because he still might like them. So, but nope, I did not wind that up yet. And I started going through all my yarn in that tote. And I have a lot of Christmas yarn in that that's not self-striping. And I've got some fall ones. And of course, when I was part of Yarnable for a couple of years, I have a lot of her stuff. And I really like her yarn too. So I just didn't know what to do. I'm seeing different things, and but nothing that says, you know, cast me on. So then I went back, and there are some Freckled Whimsies Halloween one that I wanted to do for myself. Now, I belong to her Christmas club and her Halloween club, and I think it's August. Yeah, because this isn't September yet. August should be here, both of those on Monday. So my thought process was, okay, there was a Halloween one in there that, well, actually there was two, and then a Christmas one. I've been making everybody socks, and I'm kind of wanting a pair for myself. So I pulled out one that I thought that I would like. I wound it all up and everything, and I haven't cast it on yet. I want to get Isaac's past the heel and all that stuff first, because I'd like to get his done, because his is a DK White US 3. So I wound up what I wound up, and I thought, if I really like what shows up Monday in the Halloween, then this will go to our daughter, and because she wears my socks a lot that I make her, and I know her husband likes to wear socks, but she, you know, she's getting the bulk of them from me. I will make sure that he gets a Christmas pair and that he gets a Halloween one. So this is what I pulled up. This was on her, this is fingering weight, and in her Splendid Base. This was called Free Broom Rides. This is June's colorway, and it is a 12 stripe repeat. It comes with a 25 gram mini and 100 gram yarn cake. So let me move them over here. So this is the mini. And I will do the heel and the toes out of the mini, because there won't be enough to do all three. Yes, please. I really like this. I have a feeling I might keep this one, but we'll see. So it's okay for me to do all for me too. So, but you can see all the different colors in that. I really like this. Yeah, I really like this. So I think, like I said, the cuff will be in the main color, the heel and the toe will be in that. And I will still have a little bit left over, but I don't ever have enough to do all three in a 25 gram. Normally I don't. Unless I started out with like 5 rounds of the black and go right into it, but I don't think I will because it's self-striping. So that is what I have caked up for that. And then I ordered a knitting book on hats. It's called The Art of Knitting Hats by Courtney Flynn. I saw her thing on Instagram, and this is what, there was one, a hat in here that I really liked. And it's all color work, or stranded knits, I should say, stranded knitting. So, it's a really nice book. I'll have to, that's her fall one. And it uses worsted white. And normally I do not buy a book, but it has a lot of patterns in here. It's 176 pages long. The one hat pattern I wanted was $6.99 on Ravelry. And then when I saw she had this book for $24 with all of these patterns, I just thought, nope, I'm just going to do that, because the book is very well written and everything. So I got that because I do like some of the hats in there, and I am doing, I'm moving the yarn off my lap. I will be starting, oh, my nose itches, Lindsay's hat. But I want to get a couple of these socks out of the way first, so I don't feel overwhelmed by everything. I know Layla's socks will not take long. Riker's will take just as long as if I'm doing mine, and our daughter's, and her husband's, Kevin's, will take a little bit longer. Not much, but you know, they got bigger feet because our kids are tall humans. Our daughter's almost 5'11" and wears a woman's size 11 shoe, and our son is 6'3" and a men's 13. So, and Jerry and I'm a 9'10" and he's a men's, you know, 9'10". So, but that's just how it is. So I'm just thinking that if I can get Isaac's done, then I will have 3 of the sock sets done. And then I have Kevin's Christmas one, which is DK, waiting to be knitted on. So then that would, you know, be 4 of them. And then it's just Riker, Bethany, and Layla. So, and then the socks part will be done. Well, I thought with this hat one, I thought what I would do is, because Isaac and Lindsay will be getting a knitted hat, This will be on, like I said, worsted white, so I'll be thicker, so it should go faster. And I thought for Bethany and Kevin, I would do them each a hat too. These are more like a beanie style, form-fitting down. Some of them are slouchy up on top with a, you know, pom-pom put on it. So that was my thought. But other than that, I don't have too much going on. Just trying to stay good on my plan, and so far I am, and trying to relax a little bit from yesterday, and the humidity has already set in. Air conditioning is on, and for us, our worst days, they say, are Monday and Tuesday, because we will be in the 90s, so the feel goods, as they call it, will be in the triple digits. And if we get rain, it will be probably, you know, Monday night into Tuesday if we get rain. So, but we're pretty dry. We really need rain. But it is coming up the last week of August. Landon's birthday will be the 1st of September, and then Miss Layla's is September 9th. Jerry's is the 12th. Lots of birthdays in September. And then his mom, hers is in October. Hers is one day before Riker's, and she will be 91. So her brothers all lived to be in their 90s also. They all ended up having Alzheimer's, and hers is just dementia so far, but not a good dementia. So, but 91, unreal, you know. So, but anyways, I'm going to let you go. I'm going to sit here and knit on the sock to get the heel going, and not do too much, but watch some YouTube. Watch the Lions game today. It is preseason time, basically. Their first game starts September 8th. So, and I know last year I knitted myself some Lion color socks. I think I only got one done, so I need to find that project bag in my project bag bin and get that sock done. Oh, I did do some retail shopping off from a piece of U, EWEU, in Saginaw. I bought two more yards, but one looks like Detroit Tigers, and the other one was a Christmas one that I liked the looks of it. It wasn't self-striping. And I just need to make up my mind if I'm going to continue on. If she continues on with the Christmas Club, if I'm going to continue to do it or not. I might not. I might not with the Halloween once it's done either. I've got enough sock yarn and see enough sock stuff, you know. And she always has self-striping and everything else. So, but so far, it's been very enjoyable. So thanks again, my friends, and I hope that your Saturday was a great one, and stay strong. We got this. See you soon, my friends.